Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about a change in the upcoming Postgres 17 release that improves query plans for queries that involve CTEs. Specifically, this improves the query plans where you would see a CTE scan. This is the case since Postgres 12 if either you intentionally use the materialized keyword, which ensures that Postgres treats your CTE as an optimization fence, or Postgres wasn't able to pull out for other reasons. Generally, Postgres will try to optimize things so that it looks at the whole query as one plan, meaning you wouldn't see any CTE scan in your explain plan. Now, in the case where you see CTE scans, one thing that might have been surprising to you in the past, if you took a really close look at it, is that the column statistics from columns referenced in that CTE scan weren't being propagated upwards. So that means if you're working with the results of the CTE scan, Postgres would oftentimes have misestimate because the selectivity calculations would be wrong. This commit here by Tom Lane from last November fixes that. This commit is in Postgres 17 beta 1, and we can likely expect this to be in the final Postgres 17 release in September or October. Now, let's take a closer look at the background here. Hans Buschmann posted this to the mailing list last year, where he was describing wrong row estimations of joins of CTEs slowing down queries by a factor of more than 500. Now, this is a little bit of a long report, but it was enough for community member Thomas Vondra to produce a reproducer and Jian Guo to propose a patch that addresses this. Now, the patch isn't necessarily complicated, but there was some discussion around what does the materialized keyword actually mean in a CTE. And so Tom Lane summarized it as, when we say materialized is an optimization fence, what that means is that the upper query, the one that's referencing the CTE, shouldn't be influencing the choice of the plan for the subquery inside the CTE. So that means the subquery itself can influence what the upper planner does, just not the other way around. And so as Tom notes here, exposing column statistics to the upper planner as the patch does, isn't fundamentally different from exposing row count estimates, which are already being transmitted upwards. There was one more discussion item here after the patch got committed, which is the fact that path keys are not being propagated upwards from a CTE either. We'll get back to that in a second. First of all, though, I want to highlight one more example where this will actually be improved and we can test ourselves. So this is a report by Jian Guo to the Postgres bugs mailing list. And one thing I like about this report is that it has a reproducer, even though Jan says this was originally seen on AWS Aurora, which usually the community doesn't like it if you ask Aurora questions because you should ask AWS. But in this case, Jan went through the effort of actually building a small reproducer. And so you should do this if you use managed service providers. Don't expect the community to do the legwork for you, but if you can, provide a small reproducer like this. So what Jan was essentially seeing here was that the information about how distinct the results were was not being propagated upwards. Let's take a quick look at that just to illustrate the difference between 16 and 17. So I have 16 and 17 running in a container here. I'm just going to run these steps on both of them. And then if I run the given example on 16, what we'll see is the 200 rows estimate that was essentially the concern. And then if I run the example on 17, I'll see that, first of all, the query plan has changed, which in this case is expected, right? Because Postgres suddenly got different statistics. And really the root cause here is this rows 100 estimate. Again, the reason that things changed here is because you have this hash aggregate node sitting on the outside, right? So it's not the row estimate from the CTE itself that has changed. It's the information about the columns that are being returned from the CTE, where previously Postgres essentially had no information. And now, thanks to the work by Jian Guo and Tom Lane, this is now improved. Now let's come back to path keys. So path keys are information that are attached to a path, aka the early stage of a plan node in Postgres, and they help the planner understand the sort order of that particular path, of the particular part of the plan. And so previously, if Postgres was materializing a CTE, and then you had another node using the result of it, even if the materialization caused a certain sort order to be guaranteed, either because it was an index scan of a sort order or there was an explicit sort node, Postgres wouldn't be aware of that and wouldn't be able to reuse the previously guaranteed sort order, unnecessarily adding a new sort node or potentially using different join methods. For example, a merge join would be less likely if you didn't have a particular order guarantee. Now, this patch by Richard Guo, which was committed by Tom Lane, fixes that particular problem. Now, let's take a look at an example discussed here. So first of all, you can see that this is a CTE of the materialized keyword, and it's essentially getting some unique data from one of the Postgres regression test tables and then joins it against itself. But again, it passes through an optimization fence enforced by a CTE. And I'm going to illustrate this locally where I've loaded the test data from the Postgres regression test database, similar to how we've previously discussed it in episode 108 of 5 Minutes of Postgres. So I'm going to run this here in Postgres 16, and then I'm going to run in Postgres 17 for comparison. You can see in 16, we have a nested loop join, versus in 17, we have a merge join. And really the difference is on 16, Postgres wasn't able to understand that this CTE scan had a particular sort order. So instead of adding an additional sort node, which would have made things more expensive than a nested loop, it used a nested loop. Versus here in 17, we can see that because the index only scan had a particular order already, we can reuse this order and therefore use a merge join. Now on that same example, Tom Lane pointed out something important, which is if we take out, in this example, the order by unique one, which is explicitly added into a CTE, then it doesn't work as expected. So if I run this now on Postgres 16, we'll see the exact same blend. So this doesn't make a difference in 16. Whereas in 17, we can see that it does choose a hash join now instead of a merge join. So presumably because of the other improvements on the CTEs surfacing column statistics, it still doesn't choose the nested loop here, but it does choose a hash join instead of a merge join because this here, this index only scan, doesn't know that the parent needs it in a particular order. And so if you're trying to get the benefit of this change in Postgres 17 in regards to the sorted output from a materialized CTE, and you're not seeing the expected plen, try adding an explicit order by statement so that Postgres records the path keys that are necessary for this to work successfully behind the scenes. Thanks so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.